Good morning. I'm really glad we're together today, and for lots of reasons. But given what's going on in the world, what's going on in our country, and the news from yesterday, I'm just really glad we're here together today. Just to be here, to be in community together, and to express that love and compassion that we truly are. And so I hope you feel that way too, that this is a good place to be today. And if you are joining us on live stream, we are so glad you're here. Please know that whomever you are, wherever you are on your spiritual path, you are welcome here with us. This is a place of inclusion, a place that affirms you as the creation of God that you are in truth, a magnificent creation of God that you are in truth. Again, we are so grateful that you're here. Let's stand and sing.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I'm not gonna hide it, no. I'm gonna let it shine. I'm not gonna hide it, no. I'm gonna let it shine. I'm not gonna hide it, no. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. No matter what people say, I'm gonna let it shine. No matter what people say, I'm gonna let it shine. No matter what people say, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Every day in every way, I'm gonna let it shine. Every day in every way, I'm gonna let it shine. Every day in every way, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This is light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
And we invite our prayer chaplain for today, Kari Hinn, to come forward and to create a consciousness of prayer as we open ourselves to our time together. Kari.
Good morning. Good morning. So let's start by taking a nice relaxed breath. And now breathe all the way out and let the air flow in naturally. As we breathe out gently, we center in our hearts and connect more strongly with the divine power and strength within us. And let's breathe in from everywhere and breathe out to everywhere. And again, breathe in from everywhere and breathe out to everywhere. And join me in being grateful for all those present here today, in person or online, as we feel their loving energy and interact with them. We can feel the love and compassion of everyone here that inspires us and assists us in feeling more at peace. And today, we especially appreciate Reverend Debra and Mary Donahue, who is here from Days to give our talk. Since we recently celebrated Independence Day, we give thanks for all the choices and experiences we have. Days supports people to also experience more freedom and a safe space to live while they grow through a huge transformation. Thank you, Divine, for safe spaces like Days that give hope to so many families each year. As Christmas in July continues, we give great thanks for the abundance of opportunities that most of us have, and we choose to give generously to support all those who are not experienced freedom and safety. As you go through each day, allow yourself to live, experience, and embody gratitude for freedom and choices. As we support the families at Days, may all who have experienced abuse be blessed as they transform and also experience those same feelings. Meister Eckhart once made the statement, "If the only prayer you ever say is thank you, it will be enough." So in this moment, let's say thank you, thank you, thank you. And so it is, and so it shall be. Amen.
Now let's stand and greet one another.
You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part. Imagine all the people
Joy Morgan, and I'm your celebration assistant this morning. Thank you. If you are joining us for the first time, welcome. Unity of Madison is an inclusive spiritual community that welcomes people of all faiths and backgrounds. If you would like to know more about Unity of Madison, there are information packets in the foyer. If you are online, you can request a welcome packet through the website and send an email to the address on your screen. Please join licensed Unity teacher Barry Roberts for a continuation of his journey through the book Heart-Centered Metaphysics by Reverend Paul Hasselbeck. The third of the study begins on Wednesday, the 17th of July, for 4 weeks from 6:30 to 8 p.m. It will focus on spiritual tools such as denials, affirmation, scripture, and the 12 powers to help us live for our full potential. Register for the class at the table in the foyer. The garden team will gather for a work party on Saturday, July 20th from 9 to 11. Your willing hearts and hands will keep our grounds beautiful. Please join us. Grab a friend, carefully, a family member, or your grocery list, and join us for some fun this August while supporting a very good cause. On Saturday, August 3rd, bring your Unity spirit and maybe even your Unity t-shirt, which some of you are sporting today. They look so good. As we ring bells for the Salvation Army's annual summer fundraising event. We have reserved blocks of time at two major grocery stores in Madison, Metcalf's at Hilldale, and on the west side between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m., and Metro Market on Cottage Grove Road on the east side between 8 a.m. and 4 p.m. Sign up for an hour or two and ring away the summer this day. Plus, every dollar we raise that day will be matched. There will be sign-up sheets in the foyer with a different shift. Come ring the bells and join us. Okay. Our youth ed and Family Ministry Program requests your help. They are collecting yellow, blue, green, orange, and red items that can fit in your hand. Beads, bottle caps, pom-poms, feathers, buttons, game pieces, old jewelry, Legos, pipe cleaners as long as they're clean, and please bring in and bring those things in and drop them off upstairs in the Unity Youth Ed space. Unity of Madison is looking to hire an organized and energetic office administrator to support the administrative life of the center. This is a 16-hour-a-week job position. For more information and to apply, please email Reverend Debra at the email address on your screen. Jennifer Parker, one of our Christmas in July elves and team lead, has an important invitation for us all.
Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Hello. Glad to see all of your smiling faces. I'm Jennifer Parker, one of five elves in the Christmas in July team, and first I want to just share something. Like many of us, I find myself feeling anxious about what's going on in the world, in our country, and this sentence from Wednesday's Daily Word was comforting and inspiring to me. I replenish myself from the limitless well of divine goodness, which I share freely and generously. I want to give thanks for unity, the presence of unity, this church, and the whole unity movement in terms of being there and sharing of divine goodness for all of us. Giving to DAYS, our Domestic Abuse Intervention Services, through Christmas in July is one way we share divine goodness. Intimate partner abuse victims depend upon DAYS when they're in crisis, and DAYS depends upon us in terms of communities like ours, individuals like ours in terms of giving. So thank you very much for that. I give thanks for the wonderful Christmas in July team that we have, and I'm gonna name them today, and if you're here, please stand as I call your name. Karen Lunt, Phyllis Nettesheim, Sally Ring, Michelle Honore, and me, of course. They are such a pleasure to work with. I'm also thankful today for the inspiring music by Jan Reek and Catherine Rip and Joe Rip Dieter. I had approached Jan because I was so moved by her music earlier in the year, and she agreed to share that song plus another one, so I'm so grateful for that. I'm also very thankful for Mary Donahue coming again. She's also so wonderful in terms of what she delivers to us and for her working with Reverend Debra, so thank you both for that, for I know what's going to be an inspiring message. At the end of the service, you can place cash or checks made out to domestic abuse, or just DAYS is fine. You can put it in the donation box at the table after the service. And if you are viewing this online, you can use our online donation link, or you can send a check into the Unity office and made out to DAYS, though don't make it out to Unity. Karen Lunt made a wonderful candy cane to demonstrate our generosity as we have it, so you can see that out in the foyer. So I'm going to be at the table after the service. I look forward to greeting you and seeing you. If you have any questions or comments, please approach, and I will see you then. And thank you ahead of time for your generosity.
Thank you, Jennifer. We are grateful today for our special music provided by Jan Reek. We are also grateful for Mary Donahue's presence with us, as well as your amazing work with the entire Christmas in July team. Thank you. If you would like prayer support, our prayer chaplain, Kari Henn, is honored to pray with you after the service in the prayer corner, or you can leave a prayer request in the prayer box. Please join me in our affirmation for Unity of Madison. We celebrate a world transformed by love as we co-create spiritual connection and sacred service. Pardon that moment of panic, I didn't see the daily word. But today is the 14th, and it is divine order. And as I've said to others, we're asking a lot of God today. Okay, here we go. Okay, today's word is divine order. How often have I felt disappointed when things did not work out as I had planned or hoped, only to discover a blessing I had not anticipated? Understanding that a seeming obstacle may actually be an unrecognized opportunity, I resist the temptation to wonder why the setback is happening. Instead, I pray, asking what is mine to do. I may receive guidance to wait for a better time to pursue my plan, or perhaps an insight will arise out of what has happened to be failure, showing me a way forward that will accomplish even greater good. Affirming divine order keeps me patient and trusting in right outcomes and in all situations. The scripture reading that accompanies today's daily word is from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 12. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. Please join me in saying our affirmation together. During times of uncertainty, I trust divine order. And now let's sing our meditation song.
Touch love with every
invite you now into a time of quiet and reflection. Just allow the words of our meditation song to reverberate through you with every thought, peace. With every breath, peace. Allow that peace to move in and through every fiber of your being, from the top of your head to the soles of your feet, washing you in that sense of tranquility as you feel anxiety and worry and concern just floating away. It seems that we are being reminded day by day that there is work to do in our world, in our communities. And so we ask ourselves, what is ours to do? What is ours to do? On this day, when the events of yesterday reminds us that there is indeed much work to be done, we open ourselves to the impulse of the possible within us. Impressing upon us the remembrance of our true nature. Reminding us that we are our love, created in the image and after the likeness of the divine itself. That this divine presence is expressing in and through us. We are here to love. And by loving self and others, we are expressing the divine love that we are created in and as. A love that heals, a love that frees, a love that transforms. A love that creates a world that is truly in keeping with the vision that God has for it. And as we love one another, as we respond from the impulse of that love, as we become love in action, we create a space for healing and hope in this world. To heal all the fractured parts of our community and our nation in this moment, and to heal all the fragmented parts of our own consciousness, of our own self. We create a space for hope and healing in mind, in heart, in consciousness, and in the world. And as we rest now in silence and in quietness, we rest in that peace and in that love. Be still and know. Be still and know. Be still and know that God is God in you. creator, sustainer, divine love. We thank you for this time in which we have remembered that we are your heart, your hands, your voice in expression, responding from the impulse of your divine love. This morning, we send that love to our nation, to our country, to the families of those who were struck down yesterday, to former President Trump, to all of our leaders, that we may be guided with wisdom, co-creatively, not reactively, grounded in love and compassion. We ask for healing for all those affected by yesterday. We surround them with love. We surround them with our consciousness of peace and healing and hope. And as we now begin to bring our attention back to this time and to this place, we bring with us an attitude of hopeful expectation, as we open ourselves to answer that question, what is mine to do? And so we send a blessing to the person to the left of us, to the person to the right of us, the person behind us and in front of us, to every person in this building and in our world. And grounded in love, renewed by hope, sustained by peace, we say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Spirit. And so it is, and so it shall ever be. Amen.
And sprout acts of compassion for all. everybody. I'm so pleased to be singing with Catherine Ripp today and Joe Dieter playing guitar with me. This is an original song that I wrote, and it's called Discover. Some of you have heard it before. I sang it in February. I always like to say the words to my songs before I sing them because I personally have such a hard time understanding the lyrics when other people are singing. And I think the words are so important. To discover my story is to discard the lies. Uncover the true self, the new self, and see with clear eyes. To embrace my emotions and let the false self die. To discover my story, true self arise. To love without measure my inner child. Loving parent to hold me, to keep me, to stay by my side. This spiritual journey takes me through the door to discover my own love, abandoned no more. I wrote this song after being in adult children of alcoholics and other dysfunctional families, that includes a lot of people, for about a couple years. Anyway, there's so much hope that healing can happen. I'm just thrilled to be able to share this music today with Mary here from DAIS, Domestic Abuse Intervention Services. And I'm just so grateful to be able to share this with you. Also, I did put the words for my songs up on the piano afterwards if you'd like to take a copy. So. Discover my story is to discard the lies. Cover the true self, the new self, and see with clear eyes. To embrace my emotions and let the false self die. Discover my story, true self arise. True self arise. True self arise. To love without measure my inner child. Loving parent to hold me, to keep me, to stay by my side. This spiritual journey takes me through the door. To discover my own love, abandoned no more. Abandoned no more, abandoned no more. Love without measure, my inner child. Loving parent to hold me, to keep me, to stay by my side.
This spiritual journey takes me through the door.
Discover my
own love.
Abandon no more. Abandon no more. Abandon no more. Spiritual door. Abandon no more. Spiritual door. Abandon no more. See with clear eyes. True self arise. See with clear eyes. True self arise.
Thank you so much. Thank you for letting me share.
I love that song, Jan. Thank you so much for that. Well, I have the pleasure of introducing our guest today, who many of you already know. We have been, as our slide during the announcement says, working with Dais for 23 years. I don't think our relationship with Mary goes that far back, but we are so glad she's here. So Mary Donahue is currently the Director of Development and Communications at the Domestic Abuse and Intervention Services, or DAIS, as it is commonly called. And so it is my joy to ask her to come up and share some words of healing and hope today. Mary.
Thank you so much. I'm briefly going to take a moment to start my timer, because if I don't, we could be here for a very long time. If you've been here in years past when I've had the opportunity to come and talk, I've done a more formalized thing often with PowerPoints and statistics and all of those kinds of things. But we're going to take a little departure from that today and try to make it a little bit more connective. And so first things first, I'm here to normalize losing my train of thought, forgetting words, and maybe saying the wrong thing altogether. So let's just bring flubbing up back, shall we? I always think that I prepare something when I come to speak to this group at Unity, which it happens to be one of my favorite days of the year. Maybe that should be saying to me something about maybe this doesn't have to be once a year, but anyway, we'll get there. I think about it a lot, and I think about what I want to focus on, and I think about what I want to say, and then something happens. You know, the world happens, life happens, and then I get here, and other things happen. And I listen to things, and I hear what other people bring to the day, and then all my eggs are scrambled. And I think again what it is that I'm supposed to be saying. So when one of the early songs was the most beloved in my heart, John Lennon's Imagine, it took me off in a completely different direction. And I thought maybe it would be nice to share with you the mission and vision statement of the organization for whom I work. Our mission statement reads, and I have to read it, because again, I don't have a teleprompter. Oh, there we go, I've just lost it. See, there we go, okay. Domestic Abuse Intervention Services believes that a world free from violence is possible. To work to make Dane County a safer, more just, more equitable place for people who have experienced domestic violence, their children, and the people who love them. We do believe that it is possible to have a world without violence. There's not a lot that we can look at in the headlines that makes us convicted in that belief that it is possible. But I do think about the world that we've been given and the tools that we have been given to take care of it. And one of those, really, for me and for the organization I work for, go figure, they're aligned, is belief. And I think that's really where we start at DAYS. We start by believing. Because often people who come to us who've been really profoundly negatively impacted by violence in their very own homes aren't believed. And maybe that doesn't seem logical to you. Maybe that doesn't seem even possible to you, that someone can say, really? That person doesn't seem like someone who would do that. Or that person, your abuser, never did that to anyone else in their lives. Or if that's the case, then where are all the other people who said that this is so? And it can be a very, very daunting place to come from, to start that conversation, to say something so vulnerable as I'm living in a place where I'm not safe, to have that moment of doubt that someone would begin that conversation by saying, I don't believe you, has got to be the most horrible place to find oneself. And so I think one of the things that you should know that you support when you support this organization is you support people being believed. You support people having the opportunity to pick up a telephone or to send a text or to come into our building and be believed. And when that belief begins, that's when that healing begins. So, Jan, I can't thank you enough for that wonderful song. And when you talk about that self-rising and that believing in yourself, that is where the healing begins. That's where we begin to see people believe in themselves in a way that says, I'm worthy. I have every reason to expect that I can live a life free of violence. That they begin to say to themselves, I can do this. I can make changes in myself and in my circumstance that allow me to transcend the violence. And when you do that, you get to hope. And I think the hope is all about, it's all about seeing something that you couldn't see before. It's about the realization, the actualization of something that you only dared believe in your heart, but now you see it coming true. And so I could talk to you all day about our programs and the people behind them, but these are the feelings behind them. These are the tenets, the things that we affirm every day and that we remind ourselves of every day so that we can continue to do this work in the face of a world that looks tremendously violent. We have to every day tell ourselves that this is possible so that the people who come to us can believe us when we tell them it is possible. So we have these amazing people that come to that building every morning, and they do things like answer the telephone. They're the crisis helpline people. They're advocates who help get people into shelter if that's the best place for them to be. They're people who help them talk to their children about what their children have seen and what their children have experienced. They're people who help them navigate the incredibly complex legal system, which is often a place where victims are not believed. They help them navigate their way to a place where they actually have some assurance within the legal framework that they're believed and they're safe. These people come together and they're able to do this on a basis day after day because of people like all of you. We so frequently say that domestic violence is a community problem that requires a community solution. And all of you sitting here today make me believe that that is possible. One of the harrowing things that's not often easy to share is what we're seeing in our own community. Earlier this year in February, the mayor of Madison in a press conference announced that 40% of the homicides in Dane County, sorry, Madison, I forget where I am sometimes. I'm in all of those places all at the same time. See, you can flub and it can be okay. Thank you for that. So Mayor Satya Conway Rhodes announced that 40% of the homicides in the city of Madison last year were directly related to domestic violence. Harrowing. But here's where the hope comes in. The hope comes in because our helplines are busier than ever. And maybe that doesn't seem hopeful, but for me it is. Because that says to me we're getting that message out in the community that there's help available. And that you are going to be believed. And that there is a life beyond violence. And hopefully we're really getting people before we get to that point of it being irreparably damaged. That's the hope, that someone hears that. It falls on their ears and it touches their heart and they say, that is what I'm living with, and maybe I should call somebody now. And so our helpline is busy. I want to conclude by saying what a wonderful thing for that meditation for this morning, if thank you is the only prayer. And if it is my only prayer, I can't say it enough. Jen, thank you for that song. Pastor Debra, thank you for welcoming me into your community again and giving me the opportunity. My friend. Jennifer has been a longtime advocate and friend of DAYS as an organization, and I'm a fan of hers personally. So to one of the best elves I've ever known, thank you. And I thank you all. I'm going to hang around afterwards for questions if you have them. I left my business card on the table out front if you ever want to stop by and visit us. And really, from the bottom of my heart, on behalf of all of the families we serve, thank you.
So my part today is to share why is this important for us as a spiritual community? Why is it important to us, to you as an individual? I ask you during the meditation to pray this prayer, what is mine to do? And things do seem overwhelming at times, particularly now. But we can do something, one thing. We are reminded today of Scripture, 1 John 3:18, let us love not in word or speech, but in truth and action. And it's easy for us to talk about love. It feels good. We feel a sense of joy as we talk about that experience of love and how love can transform us. But it's important for us to know that love is a verb, that we are to love one another as we are loved, and to know for others, perhaps, in that awareness of love, what they may not know or believe about themselves yet. That's what we do. We make a space for hope and healing in our hearts, in our minds, in our spiritual community, in our culture. For me, hope is the impulse of the possible, pressing on us, impressing on us the awareness of our own potential. And as Mary very wisely shared, seeing life in a different way, seeing what might be possible. Indeed, love is our nature. And if love is our nature, if love is what we are, then ours is to engender hope, that impulse of the possible. You've heard me say so often in the words of St. Teresa of Avila, Christ has no body now but yours, no hands, no voice on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which Christ looks with compassion on the world. You, you, all of you. And if love is our nature, then giving is our nature. For as that old gospel song says, you can't beat God giving no matter how hard you try. But we are created in the image and after the likeness of the divine, so it is our nature to give in love, to give from that impulse of hope, to give from that impulse of what is possible. And you are needed now. I think more than ever in my lifetime, you are needed now to step into that role, to step into that capacity, into that image that you are created to be. So we invite you to participate in this fundraiser, not only by writing a check, which we really would like for you to do, but also by participating, by asking yourself that question, what is mine to do? What can I do in this world right now to bring some measure of hope, some measure of peace, some measure of joy, some measure of the divine? God bless you.
Hello. I'm going to sing another original song. It's called Haven. And this is another song I wrote as a result of my work in that 12-step program I was telling you about. So much of recovery and from healing from any kind of trauma or even just learning happens in community. And unity has been such an important part of my spiritual growth. With all the 12-step programs that I've been in. I would love you to sing on the chorus of this song with me. So I'm gonna teach it to you right now. The chorus goes like this. Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, we are coming home. That's all the words. So can you try? And this is my heartbeat. Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, we are coming home. We do it twice. Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, we are coming home. So that's the first chorus. The second chorus is, walking on the path, I am not alone. But I want to dedicate this song to anyone that's ever felt like their heart was broken. This room is our haven, where our broken hearts can sing, where we find ourselves in one another, accepting everything. The unbearable is lessened when we share it with our friends, to be seen and heard and understood helps our broken hearts to mend. Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, We are coming home, walking on the path. We are not alone, back to our hearts. We are coming home. I am my own haven. I can choose to sing, for within myself I find myself accepting everything. The unbearable is lessened when my own true self I tend. I see, I hear, I understand, and my heart begins to mend. Walking on the path, I am not alone. Back to my heart, I am coming home. Walking on the path, I am not alone. Back to my heart, I am coming home.
Let's just sing it one more time, the chorus with we, because that's so important.
Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, we are coming home. Walking on the path, we are not alone. Back to our hearts, we are coming home.
Yeah, welcome home.
Thank you, Jan, for that piece. Now is the time to collect our offering. As we prepare to receive our tithes and offerings, please place them in your hand or place them over your heart as we affirm together our offertory blessing. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God. With the ushers, please come forward as we sing our offertory song, I Am So Blessed. Ushers, please come forward and please join me in blessing this offering. I'm keeping you busy here. Okay, so warm up some energy, please. Here we go. We are grateful for these tithes and offerings. We bless them and send them forth to do their great and mighty works. Thank you, God. And there are no children today. So we will still bless our youth, Ed, and with our youth prayer together. We now open our hearts to the children and families seeking a welcoming spiritual community filled with light and love, and so it is. Amen. And for all those children and families that are out there, let's just love them too. So here's our youth, Ed, blessing. We love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the Christ you are. And now please rise if you're able and join us in singing, Let There Be Peace on Earth.